Last year, teenager Mike Perham hit the headlines when he became the youngest person ever to sail single-handed around the world. He was away at sea for a grand total of 5 months.
I was lonely all the time. You know, there were times when I would want nothing more than to be with other people. I missed these little things such as, you know, having human contact, being able to hug someone or maintain eye contact with someone. I think being alone can deepen your spirituality. You are just totally reliant on yourself, and then, you know, then God can come into play, really. I did take a Bible. I didn't read it too much, to be honest. Yeah, a Bible is very fragile, boats are very wet. so not the best environment. I certainly questioned why on earth I was there sometimes. But then I'd realize exactly where I was in the middle of nowhere, and nothing can come close to that feeling of being so free. Plus you have no parents to tell you what to do. Did I pray? Absolutely I prayed. I'm not someone to necessarily go down on my knees and pray, but I've got a good relationship with God. You know, I'm someone who will, you know, look at God as a friend. You know, you're thousands of miles away from anywhere, and so it's great knowing that there's someone up there looking out for you.
Having safely completed the round-the-world voyage, 17-year-old Mike is up for another challenge. He's learning to drive. But passing his test isn't the only thing he hopes to achieve in 2010.
I'm setting off with three other people to reenact the mutiny on the Bounty. So there'll be four of us in a 26-foot small wooden open boat, and there's no cabin. We'll have about a handful of food a day, and we'll be hoping it rains so that we can drink.
Mike will be making the same 4,000-mile voyage that William Bligh was forced to make in 1789 after being thrown off his ship, the HMS Bounty, by a mutinous crew. And unlike on his last adventure, he'll be doing it without the aid of 21st-century technology.
There were no modern devices at all. They had a sextant, a noctant, and that's what they used to navigate. So we want to come close to that challenge, really. The nights at sea are just incredible. I would just lay on the deck and you would see shooting stars every few seconds because there's no background light and you'll just be moving along ever so gracefully. It's moments like that which I will always remember for the rest of my life.
Our next piece is an inspirational song. It's based on a traditional Irish folk tune, the Londonderry Air, better known as Danny Boy. It's been covered hundreds of times. I've even recorded a version myself. It's sung for us now in Salford Cathedral by Russell Watson. You Raise Me Up.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdens me, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. And I among your shoulders, you raise me up to more than I can be. There is no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so sometimes I think I glimpse eternity.
Can